मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आई एम लेफ्टिनेंट डॉक्टर प्रशांत अंबेकर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स, धर्मपेठ एमपी देव मेमोरियल साइंस कॉलेज, नागपुर. इन एन इनिशिएटिव ड्यूरिंग COVID-19 पैंडेमिक, आई एम हियर विथ डिस्कसिंग फ्यू एक्सपेरिमेंटल मॉड्यूल्स ऑन डिफरेंट फिजिक्स एक्सपेरिमेंट्स. मोस्टली द एक्सपेरिमेंट्स आर बेस्ड ऑन XIS kit developed by Inter University Accelerator Center, New Delhi. Before going to the experiments, I will be discussing the XIS kit. Firstly, once the basic working of the kit is understood, one can perform various experiments on it. I must give an emphasis here that the experiments based on XIS are fully computer interfaced. So let us begin with introduction to XIS kit.
Before going to the details of the experiments, I must introduce this kit first. The kit has one input section and one output section. Output means source, you can say, and this is measuring section. Here in the source section, the first key is CCS. CCS means constant current source. This constant current source can either be switched on or off under software control. The nominal voltage is 1.1 milliamps but may vary from unit to unit as the component tolerances may affect the performance. The second, PV1 is programmable voltage 1. You can set the value of minus 5 to plus 5 volt from this PV1 source. Its resolution is 12 bit, that implies a minimum voltage step of around 2.5 millivolt can be changed. The second is also PV2, but its range is minus 3.3 volt to plus 3.3 volt. Again, it is again the 12-bit resolution output. Now, there is SQ1, which stands for square wave input 1. The output of this swings from 0 to 5 volt and frequency can be varied 4 hertz to 100 kilohertz. That means the entire audible range can be covered with the help of this output. The second SQ2 is again similar kind. Then OD1 is the digital output 1. The voltage at this output can be set to 5 or 0 volts using software. Then there are waveform generator WG and WG bar provided on the source unit, which can provide a frequency varied from 5 hertz to 5 kilohertz. The peak value of amplitude can be set to 3 volt, 1 volt or even 80 millivolt. Shape of the output waveform is programmable using the GUI, since triangular can be selected. W bar is inverted WG, that means this is suppose wave with a zero phase, it will provide 180 phase. Then this is the measure section, that means input section. IN1, IN2, these are two capacitance measuring knobs. Capacitance connected between IN1 and the ground. All these black buttons or switches are grounded. Here also you can see there are four ground terminals. Then it works better for lower capacitance values up to 10 nanofarads. Result may vary a bit. Now, this frequency counter IN2 is capable of measuring frequencies up to several megahertz. Then comes this SEN, it is sensor or resistive sensor input. This is mainly meant for sensors like light dependent resistors, thermistors, phototransistors, etc. Then analog input A1, A2. It can measure within the range of plus minus 16 volt range. The input voltage can be selected from 0.5 volt to 16 volt full scale. Voltage at this terminal can be displaced as a function of time, giving the functionality of a lower frequency oscillator. That means this kit can also serve as a oscillator too. The maximum sampling rate is 1 MSPS, that means megacycle per second, 1 megacycle per second per channel. That means A1 is also capable of providing this bit rate, that means sampling rate, and the A2 can also be providing the sampling rate of 1 megacycle per second. Both have an input impedance of 1 mega ohm. So you can see 1 mega ohm is 10 to the power 6 ohm. That means it will take an amount of a few microampere current to for its performance. If the equipment gives you the current less than few microampere, it may not work properly. Then there is another terminal, A3. It can measure voltage within 3.3 volt range, that means plus minus 3.3 volt. Initially we have seen that A1 and A2 were capable of measuring plus minus 16 volt, but this A3 is little bit lower, and that means the resolution may be higher in this case. I have connected the kit to my computer and the software is opened. You will see, you can see there oscilloscope with various parameters on the right of the software window. The LED light is blinking over here. It means the connection is made perfectly.
I hope you have understood the basics of XI's kit. In order to check your understanding, I put here few questions using Google Form. Please fill it and submit it. I am thankful to Dr. Ajit Kumar sir from the InterUniversity Accelerator Center, New Delhi, for selecting my candidature to participate in the Phoenix XI's 2017 course. I would like to thank our principal, Dr. Akhilesh Peshwe, for allowing me to participate in this course. I must acknowledge here Dr. Seema Ubale, Head Physics Department of Dharampet Empedu Memorial Science College, for her constant encouragement and support. I would like to acknowledge here the assistance received by my son Supraj. Thank you. Your suggestions and queries are always welcome. Jai Hind.